WYF711, good morning, this is 2-0 with your morning weather report. The current temperature is 44 degrees. Yesterday's max temperature was 53 degrees. Now for your valley forecast. Today, temperature in the upper 70s with winds from the southwest at 5 to 20 miles per hour.
So the purpose of the Mount Washington Observatory is really threefold, and it is our hourly observations, our educational outreach, and our research that we're doing up here on the summit. We're known for our extreme weather conditions that we see, our high wind speeds, our very cold temperatures, but what complicates all of that and makes this place so dangerous is how remote we are.
On a regular basis, we do an observation once an hour, which gets fed into the models for the National Weather Service so they can provide forecasts for the Northeast. We're also using this data for search and rescue. We also, every day, as we collect our weather, we do weather forecasts for the Appalachian Mountain Club.
Now for your vertical temperature profile.
Our power used to be by generator up here. And about 7 or 8 years ago, they ran electric line up the Cog Railway, but it's not completely reliable. So we find ourselves switching about 6 weeks out of the year total between line power and to the generators.
We're likely to lose power when we've got sub-zero temperatures and 140 mile an hour winds from a hurricane. And that's the data we want to capture, is the very extreme data. That's why we're in this extreme environment. Our previous UPS solution was a number of desktop UPSs, 500 to 1500 watt UPSs. Going to the Eaton UPS allowed us to integrate the UPS solution, which is a highly efficient solution, into our three-phase system. Being over a mile up in the atmosphere, we take a number of direct lightning strikes at the summit. Since we've had the Eaton UPS in place, we've never actually lost a piece of electronic equipment that was connected to it, which we have partners at the other end of our building that are on the same grid power, and they regularly lose pieces of equipment.
Mount Washington called us to assess their system. And like with any other customer, we came up to establish the relationship with them and not immediately work on the system, but to get an overall view of the entire site and what their needs are and what their future needs are. Our overall recommendation was to get the UPS on some type of maintenance program, so where we come out at least once a year to do an inspection on the system, make sure the system is calibrated properly, it's working within the specifications, and that it is, in fact, protecting them against the 9 power anomalies that could affect their equipment. We realized that the cost to replace 16 strings of batteries would be astronomical, when they could actually reduce their battery footprint and get about 90 minutes of runtime, which give them plenty of time to respond to an issue and they would still have battery backup.
We're now going to get notification if the UPS has detected anything that's amiss within itself.
It sends not only critical alarms, but it also sends minor alarms that can be used to predict and prevent future failures.
Eaton is going to be notified as quickly as we are, and they'll probably call us that the UPS is suffering from some sort of failure.
There have been many times where a local engineer will actually show up to a customer site and the customer did not even know about it. And here we are walking in with our tools to repair the system.
The folks at Eaton, the techs, have been very, very helpful. We're actually 8 miles up an auto road at the top of a mountain, which is not an easy place to get to. And they still manage to service us on a regular basis when we need it.
It's our jobs as Eaton customer service engineers to respond to the site in a timely manner, no matter what the weather conditions are, even if it's at the top of Mount Washington. We're here to take care of the customer 24/7.
Have an awesome day, everyone. 2-0 clear.